gathering together to acknowledge and to celebrate the marriage of Talma Tauru Lupo and Julia Lamahoe, Patiseta Arina, Ellen Rose Lamahoe. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, our Lord come before. May we please start the processions of the bride. us pray. Gracious and loving God, within your presence we give you honor and praise. And we invite your Holy Spirit to witness with us and with this beautiful day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May you please be seated.
It was not my idea. It was not your idea. It was God's
woman actually not wise? Tell me, how many men out there that doesn't have a woman in their lives? And yet they live well. In fact, probably quite good. And how many women or women out there who doesn't have a man in their lives and yet they live well? And it's not good for a man or a woman to be alone, because they need God's presence. And God started to create the woman, and when the man saw the woman, he said, wow, the flesh of my flesh and the bone of my bones. For those of us who are married, when you see your spouse, do you look at her or him and say, you are the bone of my bones, or you are the flesh of my flesh? Or are you looking and say, hey, your tie is not quite straight, and look at your eyebrows and your earring? How do we see each other with a new covenant that was set within us and without us? There was God's purpose, that when the man saw the woman, when we were standing there, Mark said to me, I just can't wait. Literally, my feet is numb from standing. But Mama said, I just can't wait because Julia didn't send me a bottle to see her in her dress. And all of us are probably having these quiet mumblings too long. But for Julia and Mark, this is the day. And there is no other day. That I'll look at the woman who walks down the aisle and I'll say to her, you are the flesh of my flesh and the bone of my bones. And it's not because I decide you, but God designed us to seal a new covenant. And God was writing covenant on stones, and people broke it. Write it on animal's skin, and people burned it. Write it on paper, and people lost it. And God said, okay then, everything is broken. And I can't bring back what has been broken. I can only forgive you for what you have done, for my broken covenant. And if you are here on this wedding day with a past, you can't change it. You can only cry out to the Lord for forgiveness. Because God only forgives the past and wipes it clean. And he said, okay then, I've forgiven you and I will no longer remember your wrongdoing. I'll write it clean. Today, I'll write it in your mind. Today, I'll write it in your heart so that you no longer lost it. And when I look at you, I'll say to you, my child. And when you look at me, you say, my father. Because you are the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. Only such commitment that a covenant of today, Mark and Julia, will make it new. Like no other. Sisters and brothers, we gather together here today to witness the new covenant of today. Amen.
Can I meet the ladies and the gentlemen? Say that.
In the name of Jesus Christ, to witness and celebrate the marriage of Mark and Julia. Marriage is a gift of God in creation. Marriage is not self-seeking, but self-giving. It is the giving of one another to the other. It is an overcoming of separatedness that two become one. Marriage is a creative relationship, blessed and sustained by God, who intends that husband and wife should love and strengthen each other in good times and in bad. In Scripture, Mark chapter 10, verses 6 and 7, in the beginning, at the time of creation, God made male and female. As the Scripture says, and for that reason, a man will leave his father grandmother and unite with his wife, and the two will become one. It is to announce their commitment to this holy, creative relationship that Mark and Julia have come here today. May I please ask the families and friends, does anyone here know any reason why we should not proceed with this marriage? If not, I presume that smile and laugh is a lot. You may forever silence. Mark and Julia, we rejoice with you. We are glad to join with you in the celebrations of your marriage, to witness your vows, to pray with you, and to wish you joy in your life together. Mark, will you have Julia to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, remaining faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Did you hear him?
No. I will.
Julia, will you have Mark to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, remaining faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Thank you. I'm asking now for the parents and the families. Do you, the parents, children, family and friends of Mark and Julia, affirm and support them in their marriage relationship? You say, we do. Now it's the time for their vows. You can say after me. I, Mark, take you, Julia.
I, Mark, take you, Julia.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
Hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer. Or
in sickness and in health.
And in sickness and in health.
To cherish.
To cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I, Julia, take you, Mark.
I, Julia, take you, Mark.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, poorer. In sickness and in health.
In sickness and
to love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
So long as we both shall live.
So long as we both shall live. Can I have the rings, please?
Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving and receiving of these rings. May Mark and Julia be ever faithful to each other and continue to love as long as they both shall live. Amen. Julia, you say after me, brother. Julia.
Julia.
In token of the vow made between us.
In token of the vows made between us.
And as a sign of my love and affection for you.
As a sign of the love and affection I have for you.
Mark, I give you this ring.
As
a token of a vow made between us.
As a token of this vow made between us.
And as a sign of my love and affection for you.
As a sign of my love.
Mark and Julia, you have freely expressed your desire to be united in marriage and have made vows to each other. Therefore, I pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. May God bless you and these rings which you have exchanged as a sign of your mutual love. You may kiss the bride. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give thanks to you for creating men and women so that each may fulfill in the other. We praise you for all the ways in which love comes into our lives and for all the joys that come into men and women through marriage. Today especially we think of Mark and Julia as they begin their new life together. With them, we thank you for giving them love and the loving care of their parents, which has guided them to maturity and prepared them for each other. We pray also for their parents that at this moment of parting, they may find new happiness as they share their children's joy. Give Mark and Julia strength, we pray, to keep the vows we have made to be loyal and faithful to each other and to support each other throughout their lives. May they bear each other's burden, share each other's joys, help them to be honest and patient with each other, to be loving and wise and parent their children, and to welcome both families and friends and strangers into their home. In all their future, may they enjoy each other and continue to grow in their love for one another. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. It's time now to sign. May we please have the music? with all your people in heaven and on earth, we give you thanks for Jesus Christ, through whom all things were made, who in the fullness of time became flesh and lived among us, full of grace and truth, who in obedience suffered death on the cross and was raised in triumph that we might have life. Therefore, we worship and praise your glorious name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory and thanksgiving to you, living God, creator and sustainer of the universe. You gave us your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. From the night he was betrayed, took bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this to remember me." In the same way, he took the cup after the supper and said, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Glory to you, Lord Christ. Your death we proclaim. Your resurrection we celebrate. Your coming we await. The bread which we break is the sharing of the body of Christ. The wine which we pour is the sharing of the blood of Christ. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Draw near in faith and take this holy sacrament in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your heart with thanksgiving. May I please have the newly read cup. Thank you. We thank you with all our hearts for your mercy and grace. Grant us now in the days to come a living hope in you. And as we serve you in the world, help us to look and work for that day when at your name every knee shall bow and every tongue confess you, Lord, to the glory of God. Amen. May we please rise to sing our last hymn, Amazing Grace.
So just before everyone leaves, please feel free and welcome to join us at the reception later on tonight. The private party, the groups here will be expected to arrive here tonight at 5 p.m. So go for Chanel, grab something, I